blessed, a word often used interchangeably with lucky or privileged in our social media feeds and casual conversations with friends. Bless this mess. Hashtag blessed. Blessed to find this parking spot. Blessed to narrowly escape accident or disaster. But what does that mean for those who aren't so lucky? The brokenhearted, those who didn't or can't escape sickness or grief, those without supportive families, are those who can afford luxury vacations more blessed than those who cannot? If your bills exceed your paycheck, does that mean you are cursed? The opposite of blessed? Hashtag blessed just doesn't quite cut it for those of us with just plain messy lives, those of us familiar with misfortune of any or many kinds. Once again, our faith upends this whole idea. It's one more reason I love following the way of Jesus, which turns our world on its head at every turn. With no hint of blessings to be found in happy circumstances or prosperity, however hard won, our Bible calls the poor, the meek, the persecuted, the forgiven, those who experience trials of many kinds, blessed. And why? Because the truest blessing, the most important, is God's presence, a presence we often sense and long for more in times of trial, difficulty, in hardships we didn't ask for and didn't earn. This Advent season may be more than usual. We celebrate a God who very literally comes to be with us and who became one of us. Not to give us health and wealth, but to be among us, to give us the gift of his love, show us the way to rest, to heal. Holidays often bring a good amount of joy and cheer, sometimes also grief and hardship, darkness and pain. May you find God's true blessings this Advent and Christmas season. Regardless of what circumstances surround you, Christ comes near, and we are blessed.